Hi guys, welcome to Sharmishtha and Books. If you are new here, I want to welcome you, and if you are visiting my channel for a while, welcome back to my channel. Please subscribe to my channel for more book related updates. Today's video is very interesting. It has been due for a very long time because I promised to make a video on my April and May wrap up. Because I started some books in April and I couldn't finish it by the end of April. So I continued reading them in the month of May, and I have finally got time to talk about the books. There are some books about which I have talked before in my channel, so I will talk about them briefly here. And there are books which are new, you haven't heard them from me yet, so I will talk about them elaborately, and I will also mention and put all the links down below of the videos where I talked about the other books on which I did my review or I did my reading vlog. They are all available on my channel. Please check them out, it's fun. And without further ado, let's get started. So the first book that I finished in the month of April is A Passage to India by E.M. Forster. Now I have done a detailed reading vlog in three different parts of this book, and I discussed about the topic of the book, I discussed about my thought with you, but here I just want to mention one thing. The central theme of the book is the Indianization of religion. And it talks about different religions, it talks about multicultural in India, it talks about the protagonist Dr. Aziz, who is in a constant battle of choosing between his own identity and his patriotic view towards his nation. So it's very interesting read, and I think if you want to know more about it, you can check the links. I am providing you the links of my reading blog where I talked in details about the book. I really enjoyed this one. I love reading classic and I love reading E.M. Forster. The first book I read by him was Where Angels Fear to Tread, and I absolutely loved the book. And I mean, when I say I loved the book, I mean that book is easily one of the five most influential classics of my life. And this one was not an exception, though I had to read it for my exam, but I thank myself because I chose to read the text, and it was worth it. I really loved this one. So if you are planning to choose a classic which is not very difficult, I think you can go for this one. This has a lot of Indian reference, so you will have no hard time reading them, and also you will relate to the topic so much being an Indian. So if you are watching my video from India, I think this classic will be very relatable to you, so you can choose this one. The next book which I have finished is Mexican Gothic by Silvio Marino Gracia. Again, I have done my review on this book. I absolutely love the vibe of this book. This is a horror gothic novel. I thoroughly enjoyed the book, though I have some criticism, you can check them out. But overall, I really love the vibe of the book. It's horror, it's gothic, it's so atmospheric. It talks about a woman, Noemi, who is visiting her cousin, who is kind of present in her husband's house, and she can hear voices there. She thinks the house is haunted, and she thinks that her husband is trying to poison her. So everything that she was facing, she wrote in a letter to Noemi, and Noemi goes to visit her cousin sister, and then she will also got entangled with the mystery of the house. Very mysterious, definitely a good atmosphere, great, not a speedy read, but really enjoyable. So this was my second read of that month. The third book which I want to talk about, I am a little bit, you know, anxious to, you know, open up about this book, because the book is The Sign of the Four. I have talked about this book when I was reading it, and I told you that I am enjoying this book, but sadly that changed very soon. I absolutely hated how racist the book was. It was so racist that it made me so angry that I had to struggle to finish this book. I know it was written in that time when this matter was not talked about, but still, it's offensive. Often in this book, Arthur Conan Doyle calls the native Indian of Andaman Nicobar black-finned cannibals and whatnot. And the treasure they talk about, the possession they talk about, belongs to no one but Indians, because they robbed us. And that's a very different topic. But coming back to the topic of racism, this book is so racist. I mean, it just ruined my reading experience. That's all I can say. And I loved the short stories of Sherlock Holmes. I loved Adventure of Sherlock Holmes, Memoir of Sherlock Holmes, and I couldn't love Study in Scarlet, but at least I didn't hate that one. But this one, The Sign of the Four, was so offensive that I ended up hating this book. And now I am literally scared to read Hound of the Baskervilles. I don't know. I know a lot of you can disagree with me, a lot of you can feel different about this book. I'm really sorry guys if I have, you know, talked shit about your favorite book, but that's how I felt. It's my personal opinion that I am really uncomfortable reading something so racist. That's all. Next, I'm going to talk about a beautiful book, a very poetic, beautiful writing, and that is On Earth We Are Briefly Gorgeous by Ocean Wang. This book is everything. This book has so much emotion and beauty. And I talked about this book in my detailed review. This is very poetic. I, you know, underlined, if I don't know if you can see, I almost underline each pages from this book, because I can't stop myself from appreciating how beautifully Ocean Wong opened up his heart to us. This book is about a boy who is an immigrant, and he, his nickname is Little Dog, and it's a sensitive tale about his own identity, about his own existence, his relationship with his mother. And he is writing to his mother a letter, and his mother is illiterate, so she can't read. So he is writing a letter for her, but never going to be read by his mother. And he talks about Rulabath, he talks about his favorite authors who influenced him. He talks about how living in America changed his life, changed his perspective. And it's so personal, it almost reads like a non-fiction, but it's also so unique as a fiction that you get very involved and you feel very emotional. And there are a lot of trigger warnings. I talked about them in my video. Please check them out before picking this book. but I really loved this one. I am really excited about the next book because I kind of discovered this book magically, and this book is so magical, this book is so beautiful because it's a middle grade book, and you know how much I love middle grade books. So this one is Unadaptables by Hannah Tok. Oh my god, this book is everything. Mwah. Yes, I kiss my favorite books. Okay, forgetting the weird part, let's come back to the book. This book is about this five little orphans who were mysteriously dropped at an orphanage, Little Tulip, and their friendship is so strong. They are almost like a family. They stand for each other, they care for each other, and they will get into a journey where an adventurous journey where they will try to find out Milo's the protagonist of this book. Though the five of them are the protagonists of this book, but Milo is a little bit important because she has more layers than others. So Milo is trying to find out her parents because she believes that her parents didn't abandon her willingly. She was abandoned because of the situation, and she wants to find out her parents. And there is an evil man who is trying to buy them all, and he is a businessman and he wants to use them as laborers, and they are escaping from this person and also from the matron, who is very brutal, who doesn't take care of them and who tortures them with different difficult household chores. So it's beautifully done. I never heard of this book, and it came with Blinded with Books by Chapter One Bookstore. I will provide the link down below. So every month they come up with different titles, and you don't get to know about the titles. You just get a series of hints, and from that, if you are intrigued, you choose the book and you receive it wrapped in a brown paper. You don't know who is the writer, what is the book. You just know the genre or a few hints about the book, and then you find out a book like this. So I am really thankful to Chapter One Bookstore. I enjoyed it so much. This almost took me to my childhood, and that is what I love about middle grade books so much. So if you haven't heard of this one, which I'm sure many of you haven't, please, please read this one. It's available on Amazon. I will try to provide all the links of the books in my description so that you can buy them. And look at the gorgeous cover. And the spine is also beautiful. I am a sucker of beautiful covers. So this book is beautiful inside out. Please read this one. You will not regret. And lastly, I will talk about two short story collections that are Little Black Classics by Penguin. This came with an 80 book collection, and there are three stories, The Kiss, Two Volodoes and Gooseberries. I love the Two Volodoes and The Kiss. I loved Gooseberries, but I loved the other two more, and these are by Ivan Turgenev. I hope I am pronouncing the name right. If I am not, please forgive me. This is called Cassian from the Beautiful Lands. Okay, again, I didn't love the titled story, but I love the other one, which is District Doctor. And this is my introduction to Ivan Turgenev, and I am looking forward to read more books from him. I try to read one or two Little Black Classics between all the big novels and big books so that I can finish all the 80 books soon. And I really enjoy reading short stories and short poems, and you can also do this because what happens is that when you finish a short book like this, it really gives you a very good positive feeling that you have finished something. So if you are on a reading slump, if you cannot read anything, if you are procrastinating, if you are delaying, I think you can choose short books like this. Why I am dancing with this book, I have no idea. So that's all for today, guys. I hope you love this video. I was really excited for this one because I have never talked about so many books in a single video. Thanks for staying and thanks for tolerating me. I will come up with new videos. Stay healthy, stay tuned, and read more books. Bye bye.